Hello, Scorpio. Welcome to your 72 and you reading. Hope you guys are all doing well and welcome back to my channel if you're new here. We are looking at what is happening for your sign over the next 72 hours. You can watch this reading if you are a Scorpio sun, Scorpio moon, Scorpio rising. If you have your sun in the eighth house or Venus in Scorpio, you can watch this reading. I'm also going to include if you have your Mercury or Jupiter in Scorpio, feel free to tune in. Cross watchers are also welcome here. However, please keep in mind this reading is for the Scorpio that is watching, so it is tailored for them. Okay, so messages are for the Scorpio, not for the cross watcher necessarily. Not necessarily. For your reading today, Scorpio, we're using a couple decks here, and I almost forgot, quick announcement. I do offer personal private tarot readings. If you would like to book a reading with me, you can find my information, as always, down below in that description box, including my website and scheduling page, as well as up in the right-hand corner. Just click that eye in the sky right up there. That will take you to my scheduling page where you can book a reading at your convenience. For your 72-hour forecast today, Scorpio, we are using the Gilded, Reverie, Lenormand deck. This is the expanded edition. I believe the author is Sarah Marchetti. If you'd like more information, there is a little QR code on the back. Feel free to take a screenshot of that. I believe you can scan to get the guidebook, although I have not really had much luck with that myself. Just because I purchased this off the Wish app, and anything you purchase off the Wish app, most tarot decks and Lenormand cards, etc., will not come with a guidebook. Just in case you're shopping on there and you want to get a good deal, it's just not going to come with a guidebook, which is fine because you can often find Lenormand cards online as well. So maybe that will help someone out there that's trying to learn Lenormand cards. But anyway, for your tarot reading, we're using the Fountain Tarot deck today by Roos Books. Website here is roosbooks.com. I'll go ahead and it's hard to see. Yeah, it's right down there. Yeah, you can find that. You can find these decks down below as well in the description box at the bottom of the description box window. So let's go ahead and jump into your reading, Scorpio. I was very much called to do your reading today. We'll see what other signs pop up on my radar, but yes, let's go ahead and see what are the overall energies, like what's coming towards Scorpio or what's happening for Scorpio over the next 72 hours. What does Scorpio need to be aware of? Messages and energies. Ooh, the clouds. Interesting. That came out for Aquarius's reading. So you could be dealing with an Aquarius, but the clouds talks about confusion. Okay, something obscuring your view or reality here. I'm hearing depression as well. Something is not completely clear. Okay, there's some confusion going on in some area of your life. Let's see. What is coming in for Scorpio? Cards are a little jumpy. What's coming in for Scorpio? Next 72 hours, we have the Fox. Interesting. The Fox is kind of like the Seven of Swords in the tarot deck. This is a sly, witty person. This is sneaky behavior. This is also craftiness, cunningness. Maybe someone is trying to get away with something and cover their tracks here. Yeah, foxes, think of, what does the fox say? Nothing. What does the fox say? Nothing. Yeah, Scorpio. So maybe this is your energy. I don't know. This could be someone you're dealing with. We have a King of Clubs here, so it could be a fire sign. We have the Nine of Clubs here. I'm picking up Sagittarius's energy with those two. With these two card meanings, cartomancy meanings, but of course it could be any sign. And then we have a compass down here. So I'm thinking of like pointing your compass. So this is navigation. All right, so there could be something going on with someone's GPS, navigation, wayfinding, finding a direction here. All right, this may be an endeavor that you have to do on your own. Maybe you are. I'm just looking at how the fox is kind of looking behind him here. I do get the message of covering one's tracks or obscuring like your path forward, like not wanting anyone to kind of follow you down this road. That's the message that I'm getting. All right, well, let's see what the tarot cards have to say. And spirit, what is coming in? What is happening for Scorpio over the next 72 hours? Provide us some details here. What is happening for the sign of Scorpio over the next 72 hours? What's coming towards them? Scorpio. Three of Coins, Capricorn's energy. Some sort of collaboration here, an employment situation. Definitely work is coming through. All right, there could be a third party here as well. Let's get some more information. What's coming? What's happening for Scorpio over the next 72 hours? What do they need to be aware of? Ten of Wands. I'm hearing toil and labor. Something here is very oppressive. Something here is a lot of work. Obviously, you do want to be successful. Just want to draw your attention to the fact that we do have Sagittarius's energy here. I mentioned that Capricorn Sagittarius coming through. Seems like something you're doing with your employment is a lot of work here, a lot of effort, or maybe this is someone you're dealing with. All right. So I'm hearing burdens, duties, and responsibilities are overwhelming here. What's coming in for Scorpio over the next 72 hours? What's happening for Scorpio? The Nine of Wands, more Sagittarian energy. Okay. Yeah, it's an uphill battle here. Of course, this is the Wounded Warrior. So I'm getting, it's a struggle to get to the top of this mountain, or it's a lot of hard work, or it's a lot of effort or strength. Something is very strenuous. Are you doing manual labor or heavy lifting? I'm seeing someone here dragging something. I'm hearing farm equipment or agriculture. You could be doing something where you're working with the land, or you're working with construction equipment. I'm seeing a lot of like rebar or like metal rods or steel rods, or you could be doing some heavy lifting this week. Let's see what's coming in for Scorpio over the next 72 hours. The Four of Coins, boundaries and resources, saving your money. Okay. Well, there is a progression here from the three to the four. So I do feel like there's some earning potential here, but for the amount of work that you're doing, or maybe this is someone you're dealing with, it seems like it's very little. So this could be someone who's employed, and I'm getting kind of like blue collar work, or someone that has a job in construction or something like that. But let's see. Clarify the Three of Coins. Why is Three of Coins here? The Devil. All right, so you could be dealing with the Capricorn. Someone here is obsessed with their job. Someone here is, could be a workaholic. I do get, there could be some toxicity in the workplace. Why is the Ten of Wands here then? Or you have a very specific, you have, someone works in the industry, for example, the music industry. I heard photography. Okay. So someone could be an artist. But clarifying the Ten of Wands, we have the Ace of Cups, the Three of Wands, and the Eight of Coins. Well, you guys are not making my job easy today. I only asked for one card. But with the Ten of Wands, I'm hearing it's a labor of love here. And with the Three of Wands, I feel like someone is, I'm really getting it's a tug of war here at work with the Eight of Coins. There's a lot of building and production. There's a lot of manual labor going into something. It feels like someone is in a very physically demanding profession, okay, or is doing physically demanding work here. Whatever this is, there's no doubt about it that someone is putting their whole heart and body and energy into it. It's very physically demanding. It's demanding your focus, or it's demanding their focus. The only thing I would say is that there's an obsession here regarding one's work. I'm hearing work ethic or responsibility. Someone could be overdoing it almost with these cards. It's very intense labor. Clarify, then someone could be in labor as well. Why is the Nine of Wands here? We have the Emperor. Okay. Taurus, Leo, and Aries. So you could very well be the boss here, or you're dealing with someone else's boss, or this is your boss here. It feels like they're very demanding of your time and energy, and there's a drive for perfection as well. I'm also getting a message regarding control. Because the Emperor can be a very controlling energy. It's Aries, right? But he is obsessed with structure, rules, discipline. Things have to be done in a certain order, in a certain way, and there are boundaries and there are things here that you have to abide by. But it feels like it's an uphill battle. I said that in Leo's reading. It's like we're scaling a mountain here and we're up on, we're a little bit past midway of Mount Everest here. And it's like the last stretch is going to be very, very excruciatingly strenuous. But tell me more about, tell me about the Four of Coins. Why is the Four of Coins here? We're going to have to go back and even out these rows. But what I'm feeling here is that the cards are just coming out the way that they want to right now. Verify the Four of Coins. We do have the title card and the Seven of Cups. I'm seeing someone writing an email here or a letter. There seems to be some confusion or someone is looking at their options when it comes to a relationship. This says the Four of Coins, but it almost feels like the Five of Coins. I do get a message regarding boundaries here. Your energy is here with the Seven of Cups, so I know that you're in this reading. It's just very Sag heavy. I also get a lot of Capricorn. I'm hearing the word bewildered or bewilderment. Someone could be feeling bewildered or lost here. And looking for options when it comes to something here. But let's go back in and clarify the Three of Pentacles with the Devil one more time. Let's go over the cards one more time to even out these columns here. Why is the Three of Pentacles and the Devil here? There's an important collaboration here. It could be involving three people or more. When it comes to your work environment, when it comes to your job, we do have the Wheel of Fortune. So you are on your fated journey here. This is part of your destiny, is to be working at this job, in this profession, on this platform, in this industry. There are big changes happening though. Okay, there is a lot of growth, expansion, and change happening where you work. So expect, however things are, they're not going to stay the same. In fact, I feel like there could be an increase in your workload. All right. And I'm also feeling like you need to pull people over onto your side for some reason. Like I was hearing something about like bringing allies over, bringing people over to help you. Or when I speak of a tug of war here, it could feel like a struggle to get people onto your side. But nevertheless, I feel like you are completely consumed by your work this week and putting on the finishing details of some project. Why is... Let me get one more on the Nine of Wands and the Emperor. Clarify the Nine of Wands and the Emperor, please. Yeah, your energy is pretty dense, Scorpio. It's pretty dense. the Knight of Wands. But you're enthusiastic about it. Nevertheless, there could be opportunities for travel. Maybe you have someone here running errands as well. Someone here is a little bit of a show-off. I do get with the Knight of Wands here, which is different energy than the Emperor. There is someone here that could be a little bit flighty. They're in and out. This could be someone that works underneath you, like they're, for example, an employee. Or if this is an aspect of your personality, Aries is coming through very strongly in these cards. One more on the Four of Coins, the title card, and the Seven of Cups. I almost feel like someone's at boot camp or in the army or... Yeah, someone could be away at... I'm hearing it's very frugal this feels very frugal to me. You could just be saving your money at this time, being really good about not spending a lot of money, conserving your resources. I'm hearing pennies on the dollar. Okay, we have the Tower. That's your energy. You could be trying to reach out and communicate with someone here. The Tower could indicate a separation as well or some shocking news. This could actually be someone sending you a letter, Scorpio. You may be bewildered by this letter that you're receiving. It could have to do with boundaries, finances, savings and loans, or maybe you could be shocked to find out that there's not much. Four of Pentacles, someone is really holding on to something here pretty tightly, not opening up. Why is Three of Pentacles, the Devil, and the Wheel of Fortune here? We have the Fool, Aries energy. I have like this strange feeling while I'm doing your reading where it almost feels like I'm trying to control something that is just so big in my life. It's like, there's moments here. There's a lot of, there's a lot of cards here that talk about control, boundaries, toil and labor, heavy lifting, work. And then we have the Fool here and the Knight of Wands, like this breaking free energy, foolishness or foolish behavior, or just like wanting to just jump off a cliff and like leave it all behind or just take the leap. Interspersed here. And I'm hearing like at the end of the day, you have a little bit of time for yourself where you can go off and do whatever you want. But the majority of your days here are quite structured, it feels like. Can I get one more card on the Nine of Wands, the Emperor, and the Knight of Wands? All this Aries, Sag energy. The Four of Cups. Yeah, from the Ten of Wands to the Nine of Wands, I almost wonder if you are burning yourself out willfully here at this job or occupation. There's not a lot of pentacles here, so I'm wondering like where is the money going or the finances? It feels like you have either you could be living on a very small salary, or you are being extremely frugal when it comes to your spending. Maybe not spending at all this week. It's just all work. A little room for play. There's not a lot of pleasure cards here. Like the Nine of Cups would be one of your cards. The Eight of Cups, even the Seven of Cups is here. I'm just wondering, are you feeling a little bit lost in your relationships, or have you just been putting all of your energy, time and energy into work? And then I see a letter coming in here, but it doesn't seem like there's much attached to it. This could come as a surprise for someone. Maybe you are hoping for more, or you have been giving a lot of yourself and it seems like not much return coming in. Underneath the deck, we do have the Hanged Man. Look at something from another perspective. Wow, Pisces energy is here. So remember, keep in mind, this is just over the next 72 hours what I'm seeing. The Six of the Lenormand card here, the cloudiness, we have the Neptune clouds of confusion. Here with the Seven of Cups and the Tower, and I'm wondering if, like I said, this is Sagittarius's energy here with the Nine of Clubs, and we have that up here. The confusion has to do with, you know, the Nine of Clubs really, or the Nine of Wands, Nine of Wounds, talks about the wounded warrior, right? It's like you think you know what to expect, so you prepare for the worst. And, it's having your guard up, of course, and constantly having to prove yourself. Like I said, it's an uphill battle, at least in this depiction. But in this card here, we have the Fox. And the Fox is someone that is, like I said, cunning, witty, sly, perhaps someone covering their tracks here, someone that doesn't want to be seen, found, heard. What does the Fox say? Nothing. So it's kind of like, you know, someone is like shutting up and getting to work and not talking and just putting in the effort, but it almost feels like, is it really bringing you... why isn't this bringing me satisfaction? Why am I feeling confused, lost and confused at the end of the day? It's like someone is having a realization here that something just shouldn't be that confusing or that hard to do. Why is something so hard? Why is something so difficult? Why is there all this effort being put into something? For what? So anyway, and then we have the Compass here, which is like, you know, maybe needing to reorient yourself or figure out, like, I'm also thinking of like your North Node. Someone could have their North Node in Sagittarius, Aries, Capricorn, Scorpio, Cancer's energy. So anyway, Scorpio, this is what I have for you. Remember, just the next 72 hours, what I'm seeing coming for you. So hopefully this did help someone out there, and you do resolve whatever these clouds of confusion are and find out who's been playing games, who's been doing something on the sly, who's been sneaky, who's been cunning. Maybe it's a Sagittarius. I'm not sure. Anyway, best of luck, Scorpio. Thanks for tuning in, and I will see you guys back soon.